Hey there, welcome back to my channel. My name's Georgina and I am the Honest Vocal Coach. I teach singing all day every day when I'm not making videos like this one. If you want me to react to your singing and help you improve, my links to Patreon are down below, so hit me up. So it's Technique Tuesday. And today is my top 10 female musical theatre songs you should not sing unless you are awesome. Now, if you haven't seen, a few weeks ago I did the top 10 pop female songs that you shouldn't sing unless you're awesome. And this week we are looking at musical theatre. Yay! Oh yeah, it's my thing. I like a bit of musical theatre. So this will probably give you a bit of an insight to me and the kind of stuff that I enjoy singing and the stuff that I enjoy teaching and getting involved in. I have put these clips together myself. I've not used other clips like I do in some of the vocal battles and reaction videos and stuff. This is my selection, so it's taken me a bit of time to put them all together. But this is my top 10 of songs you should not sing unless you are awesome, musical theatre edition. There will be some songs that you'll find, but you missed that out. But you missed that out. So let me just mention a list of songs that are not in the top 10 but are equally difficult, or leave them alone because everybody sings them too much. We've got Popular from Wicked, Everything's Coming Up Roses from Gypsy, Don't Cry For Me Argentina from Evita, Let It Go, obviously, Frozen, I Give My Life For You from Miss Saigon, one of the most difficult character parts to play, Movie In My Mind, also from Saigon, Burn from Hamilton, and finally, Pulled from The Addams Family, equally a difficult song. So let's start the top 10. Where's my headphones?
Why are pretending he's beside me? I walk with him till morning. Without him, I feel his arms around me. And when I lose my way, I close my eyes and he has found me.
Okay, so Carrie Hope Fletcher, very famous in the whole musical theatre arena. She's a popular girl. She's done pretty well for herself over the years, most recently doing Heathers. She's just doing the Les Mis concert that's taking place this year. She is a talented singer. I like her version of this. I think she sings it very well. It's well acted. And it's a good song. It's just unfortunately overdone. It gets done a lot of auditions now. I think it's important to try and be a bit fresher and not do the same old audition songs.
I know it's only in my mind that I'm talking to myself and not to him. And although I know that he is
so, the great Lea Salonga, or Lea Salonga, I'm not sure how we pronounce it there. She's just like a goddess for musical theatre. Oh my god. Yeah, her version of On My Own, equally good, but I would say definitely more dramatic than Carrie Hope Fletcher's version. Also, she's probably got one of the biggest mouths in musical theatre. If you notice the way she's so clean and clear and precise with all of her diction, she's just awesome.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by. When folks smile, I
will you didn't expect that, did you? Did you? No.
I dream of love and never die. I pray that God would be forgiven.
Such a huge song, this one. Shouldn't be sung by certain age ranges. You've got to be mature enough to sing this song. It's emotive, it's passionate, it's heartbreaking, it's all of these things. And when Susan Boyle did it, it was just like, It was brilliant. It was a stroke of genius, and she sang it so very well.
When dreams are made and used and wasted, the walls of ours seem to be made. No silent song, no wine untasted. But the tigers come at night with their voices soft.
So this song is in my list purely because it can be overdone now, and it's so emotive and dramatic. You gotta get it right, and if you can't put that across, leave it alone. And again, Leia Salonga, oh my god. I think it's tremendous. That shame line is so difficult to make sure that you have the power at the end of it and not just kind of run out of puff. And it's, you've got to belt it, it's got to work, and she's just brilliant at it. The Anne Hathaway version in the film, way more about the acting than the singing, whereas Leah's version, Leah, she, it's both. Brilliant. Yeah. A truly stunning song, With You from Ghost. It's an outstanding choice, but you've got to tap into that emotion. You can't just sing it. It's got to be acted first, then sung. It's such a desperate song. It comes from a place of like absolute shock and desperation, and yeah, it's a tough one. You got to do it right.
And putter, life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade.
Now, so far on this one, I'm not all that impressed. Now, this song is very difficult. You gotta be good at it. And she's gasping in between each line, and it is obviously slower than the original. That's cheating. It needs to be fast. Not feeling this either. Look at Barbara's face. She's like, watch this. Yeah, Adina, I think you are the best alphabet ever. You've got a harsh voice. And I don't mean harsh as in like awful, but it's a hard sound. And it works for some songs, but that, not the best. But like, you can tell Barbara gives her opinion too. She's like, no, no.
Ready for me, love, cause I'm a comeback. Flowers fade, the fruits of summer fade.
Ooh, moving on to the Phantom now.
So adorably, but please promise me that sometimes you
will fade. Wait. It would have been wrong for me not to put Phantom of the Opera in this list. Oh my god. It is one of the most difficult roles in musical theatre, the role of Christine, because of the true height of the voice. Not that you know, many singers have that range. It's not easy. It is, it's almost like a, it's a crossover like the old classic musicals, things like Oklahoma and all of those kind of musicals, where the voice is a little bit more on the classical side. You have to use that. So yeah, think of me, very difficult. I have done this song before myself. I think there's a recording of it somewhere abouts on the internet. I'll try and find it and put a link down below. And this end bit, it's tough. You've got to get it right. And Jackie Evancho, she does a good job. Okay, Sarah Brightman doing Wishing You Were Somehow Here Again. I found this video on the, you know, the mystery of YouTube, and it's really difficult. It's at a specific height the whole time, and it does come down from head voice to chest occasionally, but you've got to keep that heady tone, otherwise it sounds bizarre. It's got an awkward key change on the second verse. The passing bells and scarter, that bit. It's not an easy song to do. So unless you're awesome, leave it alone.
Sometimes it seemed if I just breathed, somehow you'd be here. Wishing I could hear your voice again, knowing that I never would. Dreaming of you.
It's quite spooky, isn't it, walking through a graveyard?
Pardon me, is everybody there? Because if everybody's there, I want to thank.
Oh, okay. I would love to be able to do this song. I use this song all the time with my students to show them breath control. Now, this first version is Katie doing it, and you can tell she's struggling. She's gasping to do it, trying to make sure she gets all the words in. But then you'll notice that on the next clip, which is Julie Andrews, she totally nails it. She does suck the air in a little bit, but it's not anywhere as this girl.
Thank you all for coming to the wedding. I'd appreciate your going even more. I mean, you must have lots of better things to do, and not a word of it to Paul. Remember, Paul, you know the man I'm going to marry, but I'm not, because I wouldn't ruin anyone as wonderful as he is. But I thank you all for the gifts and the flowers. Thank you all. Now it's back to the showers. Don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today. Listen, everybody, look, I don't know what you're waiting for. A wedding, what's a wedding? It's a prehistoric ritual where everybody promises fidelity forever, which is maybe the most horrifying word I've ever heard, and which is followed by a honeymoon where suddenly you realize you settled with a nun and want to kill me, which you should. So listen, thanks a bunch, but I'm not getting married. Go have lunch, because I'm not getting married. You've been grand, but I'm not getting married. Don't just stand there. I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today. Listen, everybody, look, I don't know what you're waiting for. A wedding? What's a wedding? It's a prehistoric ritual where everybody promises fidelity forever, which is maybe the most horrifying word I ever heard, and which is followed by a honeymoon where suddenly he'll realize he's saddled with a nut and want to kill me, which he should. Thanks a bunch, but I'm not getting married. Go have lunch, because I'm not getting married. You've been grand, but I'm not getting married. Don't just stand there. I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul that I'm not getting married today.
Do you know what? I show this video to students every so often, and so many people didn't know who Julie Andrews is. It makes me feel really old, and like, you don't know who Julie Andrews is. If you say Mary Poppins, they go, ah. Okay, really, really tough song, this one. This is right up there, but it's like belt central, this. I did try and find some really good clips, but, you know, I couldn't find Kerry Ellis doing it. Couldn't find, you know, any of the greats singing this song. So I did find this one, and it does show it, but not quite as well as the others that are probably out there.
Somebody tell somebody.
okay. We're moving on to the big ones now. We've got, and I am telling you, and listen, there's an equally difficult here from Dream Girls. Shockingly difficult.
I'm not living with it. I don't wanna be free. I'm staying, and you.
She's so superb. She's doing such a good job on The Voice UK right now, isn't she? She's brilliant. She's a force to be reckoned with, isn't she, Amber Riley? Oh my God. It's close to the over-singing mark, but it's the song you have to do that with. It's just gritty and awesome. Now, I would have put Beyonce in this clip, in this video, but unfortunately, the YouTube say, no Beyonce, and it always gets cut out of my video, so unfortunately, I'm not putting it in this time round. But I do like Beyonce, I'm just not able to react to it. Ah, okay, we're now reaching number two and number one of my list. This is Ariana Grande doing The Wizard and I recently at one of the galas for Wicked. And it's pretty good, actually. It's good. I've seen her do this over the years, and it's changed from more of a musical theatre style to sort of a pop version. But let's take a look.
Once I prove my worth, and when I meet the wizard, what I've waited for since birth, and with all his wizard wisdom, by my looks, he won't be blinded.
Oh, Alex! He gets everywhere. You see the MD there? He works with Dear Evan Hansen, and he works on Hamilton. He's just like one of the best musical directors ever. This is weird, I know, and probably got nothing to do with the singing, but she's got one fingernail not painted. How strange. Okay, now we're talking. Dina doing it, oh yeah.
For half of Ozzy's favorite team, the Wizard and Love.
tongue. A scary face at the end. And this next clip, oh God, I could not have it. It's like Superfruit. It's Mitch and Scott. Oh my God.
So if you can't avoid me, look toward the western sky. As someone told me lately, everyone deserves a chance to fly. And if I'm flying solo, at least I'm flying free.
Look at that green paint. What was he thinking? It don't matter, his voice is incredible.
To those who ground me, take a message back from me. Tell them how I am defying gravity. I'm flying high, defying gravity. And soon I'll match them in renown. And nobody in all of us, no wizard that there is or was, is ever gonna bring me down.
It gives me the shivers every time. That power, and it's just... I hope you enjoyed watching my top 10 songs you should not sing unless you're absolutely awesome female musical theatre edition, as much as I enjoyed watching it as well. There's some great songs in there. There's probably songs I've missed out, but I have been working on it for a while trying to remember all of the songs. So it's possible I've missed some. So which ones do you think should have been in the top 10? Do let me know in the comments below. Let me know what kind of top 10s you want to see. And don't forget to subscribe and ring that bell. See you guys later. Bye, loves.